Hey guys, how's it going? So in this video, we will take two popular budget laptops at $500 price point on Amazon, and we are going to pit both these laptops against each other. So on one hand, I've got the Acer Aspire 5 Slim Series laptop, and on the other hand is the HP Notebook 15. This is the 2020 edition. So I've already reviewed the Acer Aspire 5 laptop here on this channel. Please find a link in the video description below if you are interested in watching a detailed review of that laptop. But for this video, I want to do a head-on battle between Acer and HP laptops. So both these laptops, we will put them in a grueling 5-round match, and let's see who comes out on top, who emerges as the winner, and who comes out as the loser. Let's find out. Okay, round 1, and this is all about the CPU performance. So both these laptops, they are powered by Intel's 10th generation CPU. But just because Intel calls them 10th generation, that doesn't mean they come from the same family. So Intel has actually muddled the water with their 10th generation naming convention, and I honestly don't like it. So let's take a look at this chart to sort things out. Acer laptop is powered by Intel Core i5-10210U processor, which belongs to Comet Lake family. While HP laptop, it's powered by Core i5-1035G1 processor, and this one is from the Ice Lake family. Ice Lake family CPUs are built using Intel's latest 10 nanometer process technology, while the Comet Lake CPUs are actually using the older 14 nanometer process technology. For some bizarre reason, Intel has decided to name both these CPUs as their 10th generation CPU. Now both these CPUs, they have 4 cores and 8 threads. They also have the same exact cache amount of 6 MB. Both CPUs operate at the same thermal envelope of 15 watt TDP, but the similarity ends here. The main difference between these two CPUs is the clock frequency. So Intel has been optimizing their 14 nanometer process node for the last 5 years. So while Intel can squeeze out faster clock frequencies on their older 14 nanometer process technology, the current 10 nanometer CPUs, they are running on slower clock speed. And this is true for both the base clock frequency as well as the turbo clock frequency. So let's take an example. The Ice Lake processor, its base clock frequency is 1 GHz. And if you compare it with the Comet Lake processor, it's actually clocked at 1.6 GHz. Similarly, the turbo clock frequency on Ice Lake is 3.6 GHz, which is much slower than the 4.2 GHz on the Comet Lake processor. So does that mean Intel's newer 10 nanometer Ice Lake chip in the HP laptop, is it slower than the older 14 nanometer Comet Lake chip in the Acer laptop? Well, to answer this question, we will actually have to take a look at some benchmarks. Let's start with the single thread benchmark. So Ice Lake CPU in the HP laptop, it scores 2,392 points, whereas the Comet Lake CPU, which is in the Acer laptop, that scores 2,294 points. So that's a 4.3% performance win by Ice Lake CPU over the Comet Lake CPU. This is really interesting because Ice Lake processor is clocked at 1 GHz, yet it managed to beat Comet Lake processor, which was clocked at 1.6 GHz. So why is the slower clocked Ice Lake processor faster than Comet Lake? The answer is Intel's newer micro architecture in Ice Lake CPU. So remember guys, Comet Lake, it's still recycling the older Skylake architecture, which was launched back in 2016. So these two processors are very different from each other when it comes to their micro architecture. Now let's take a closer look at the overall performance of these processors by incorporating the multi-threaded benchmarks. Ice Lake CPU scores 8,806 points, while Comet Lake scores 8,521 points. So that's a 3.3% overall performance win by Ice Lake CPU. Honestly, it's not that impressive. One would expect a newer microarchitecture CPU from Intel to be faster than, 3%. I think Intel needs to bump up the clock speeds on their Ice Lake CPUs. And the reason why they are running it at slower clock speed right now is because the 10 nanometer process, it's not fully ramped up and they haven't fully optimized the 10 nanometer processor. So I expect down the line, Intel will release, Ice Lake processors running at faster clock speeds. Anyway, the HP laptop, it still wins this round. It was a very narrow victory, but after first round, HP leads Acer by 1-0. Okay, now we are in second round, and this time it's all about the RAM and the SSD storage. So Acer Aspire 5, it comes with 8GB of DDR4 RAM and 512GB of PCIe NVMe SSD. HP, on the other hand, it doubles the storage and it also doubles the RAM. So that means 16 gig of DDR4 RAM and 512 gig of PCIe NVMe SSD. This gives HP an advantage over Acer, especially when it comes to running productivity software like Microsoft Office Suite and various photo and video editing software. More RAM also allows opening multiple tabs in, you know, your Chrome browser without any slowdown. By the way, if you want to increase the RAM on your Acer laptop, it's very easy. All you need to do is open the back of the laptop by removing about dozen screws and prying open the back blade. This will give you direct access to memory slots inside the laptop. So Acer laptop, it has one DIMM slot available for memory upgrade. Interestingly, Acer has soldered the existing 4GB RAM to the motherboard. So this soldered RAM cannot be removed, but you can add an additional 8GB or 16GB RAM in the available DIMM slot. So if you choose to do that, you will end up with either 8 plus 4, so that's 12GB of RAM, or 16 plus 4, so that's 20GB of system RAM. Upgrading the RAM will dramatically improve the performance of your Acer Aspire 5 laptop. By the way, you can also increase the storage by adding another SATA 3 SSD in Acer laptop. So I will throw a link in the description below of compatible memory modules as well as the SSD that will work with Acer Aspire 5 laptop. Also check out my video where I show how you can upgrade RAM and SSD on your Acer laptop. It's linked below in the description. But since HP laptop comes with double the RAM and double the SSD storage, it wins the second round, and now HP has taken a solid lead of 2-0 over Acer. Okay, now we are in round 3, and this round is all about the display quality of the screen. So both laptops, they have a large 15.6 inch screen. But the similarity ends here. Acer has a full HD screen with 1920 by 1080 resolution. HP on the other hand, it comes with only 1280 by 720 resolution screen. So that's 720p. I honestly cannot believe HP wants to sell a 15.6 inch laptop running at 720p resolution screen. So in the year 2020, that should be criminal. I mean, seriously, even mid-range Android phones, they come with 1080p screen. At least the screens on both these laptops, they use IPS panel. So even though HP screen is lower resolution, it is touch enabled. So that's one bonus. And Acer, on the other hand, it does not have a touch screen display. So the displays on both these laptops, I think they are plenty bright and they output about 200 nits of brightness. The colors also look quite vibrant, and both laptop screens, they support wide viewing angles. But I will have to give this round to Acer simply because 720p resolution screen on a 15.6 inch laptop, it just doesn't cut it. I don't know what HP was smoking when they made this decision. So Acer wins this round, and now the scores are 2-1 in favor of HP. Okay, now moving on to round 4, and round 4 is all about the keyboard and trackpad. So both these laptops, they come with a full size keyboard. The keys don't feel mushy and provide good tactile feedback. Acer keyboard supports backlighting, which is unfortunately missing in HP laptop. I'm a huge fan of backlit keyboards because they allow you to type in any lighting situation. And I think that's really great for students because, you know, if you are taking notes in your classroom or conference room where it may be dark, you know, like say PowerPoint presentation or, you know, some kind of a slideshow, then a backlit keyboard is really very helpful. Now the trackpad on both these laptops, they are large and they support multi-finger gestures. So I'm happy with both the trackpads. So overall, I think this round, it's a very close one, but I will have to declare Acer the winner of this round. And it's largely because of the backlit keyboard. So after round 4, the scores are now tied at 2-all. Okay guys, so we are now in the 5th and the final round, and it's all about the price. So which one of these two laptops gives you the best bang for bucks? So at the time of making this video, Acer Aspire 5 laptop, it was selling for $580, while the HP laptop was going for $518. So that means HP laptop is about $60 cheaper than Acer. But is it a better value? That's the more important question, right? For an extra $60, Acer is giving you a full HD IPS panel, but it's skimping on RAM and SSD storage. HP, on the other hand, it doubles the RAM and SSD, but then it cuts corners, you know, when it comes to the display, and you get an inferior 720p display. So this is going to be a tough round. On one hand, we have got better display and we have got a better backlit keyboard. But on the other hand, we have more system RAM and we have more storage. I think I will have to go with Acer Aspire 5 laptop and award it the winner of round 5. Now, my reasoning is very simple. You can easily upgrade the RAM and SSD on Acer laptop, but you are stuck with 720p screen on HP, you know, that can't be upgraded. So if you buy an HP laptop, there is no way you can improve the, you know, the screen quality. Now, in my opinion, the screen quality, it's really important when you are picking a laptop. After all, that is what you will be looking most of the time when you are using the laptop. So that means Acer Aspire 5 comes out from behind and wins the contest by 3-2. HP, I'm not taking a dump on HP. I think HP has made a good laptop. I especially like the configuration, 16GB RAM and 512GB of SSD storage. I also like the fact that it has a slightly faster and newer Intel processor, the Ice Lake processor. But HP really dropped the ball on screen quality. If the screen size was 12 or 13 inches, then 720p resolution might have worked. But for a 15.6 inch screen laptop that sells for around $500, 720p screen, it's a very tough sell. So what do you guys think? Would you prefer Acer Aspire 5 or would you prefer the HP laptop? Please let me know in the comment section below. I hope you guys found this video useful. If you have any questions regarding both these laptops, please leave them in the comment section below and I will try to help you guys. Please like this video and subscribe to TechnoPanda for more videos like this. Also check out technopandareviews.com for more reviews focusing on laptops, gaming PCs, TVs, monitors, and other gadgets. So again guys, thanks for watching my video and I will see you in my next one. Bye.